Hello, my name is Anne Tebo. I am an associate professor of pathology at the University of Utah School of Medicine and the medical director of autoimmune immunology for ARUP laboratories in Salt Lake City, Utah. I'm going to spend the next few minutes talking about a new laboratory test called Phospholipase A2 Receptor IgG Antibody for the diagnosis and management of primary membranous nephropathy. Membranous nephropathy is a renal disease associated with nephrotic syndrome and glomerular immune complex deposition characterized by widespread subepithelial deposits. It may occur as a primary disease or may arise secondary to diseases such as SLE, some cancers and infectious diseases, amyloidosis, paraproteinemia, or drugs. Primary membranous nephropathy is responsible for about 80% of membranous nephropathy cases. While membranous nephropathy is seen in all ethnic or racial groups and affects individuals of both sexes, primary membranous nephropathy is more common in white males over 40 years of age. End-stage renal disease may occur in about a third of patients with primary membranous nephropathy. Recently, IgG antibodies to an N-type phospholipase A2 receptor protein have been identified in patients with primary membranous nephropathy and are thought to occur in about 70 to 80% of treatment-naive cases. The symptoms of membranous nephropathy may be associated with primary or secondary causes of nephrotic syndrome. For primary causes, minimal change disease, focal segmented glomerulonephritis, hereditary nephropathies are usually suspected. Thus, the differential diagnosis may include a number of diseases based on the patient's age, symptoms, and clinical history. Thorough physical examination, imaging, biopsy, and laboratory analysis may be warranted to rule out and/or confirm diagnostic suspicion. Understanding disease pathogenesis is crucial in guiding laboratory evaluation and treatment. Evaluation of primary membranous nephropathy typically begins with basic laboratory tests for nephrotic syndrome, which includes testing for the presence of protein in urine, as well as assessing blood levels for albumin and lipids. Several other clinical conditions are implicated in the differential diagnosis of membranous nephropathy. Therefore, specific markers for the common secondary causes of membranous nephropathy, such as autoimmune and infectious etiologies, may be required. Further laboratory evaluation for drug exposure, cancer, and genetic involvement would be indicated by the patient's clinical symptoms, clinical history, and age. To confirm or rule out a diagnosis of primary membranous nephropathy, testing for IgG antibodies to phospholipase A2 receptor is important. With the identification of the phospholipase A2 receptor as the antibody target in primary membranous nephropathy, detection and quantification of these antibodies in suspected patients is now a possibility using a variety of immunologic methods. ARUP laboratories offer a cell-based assay with phospholipase A2 receptor transfected cells and non-transfected controls. The cell-based assay is characterized by excellent specificity and comparable sensitivity to the ELISA. Patient samples are screened at 1 to 10 dilution and positive results titered to endpoint concentration that allows for more accurate risk estimation and the possibility to monitor changes in antibody concentration over time. Due to the excellent specificity of the cell-based assay, some laboratories may screen for phospholipase A2 receptor antibodies by ELISA and confirm positive results using this method. However, ARUP laboratories offer a single test which is more reliable and robust to detect and quantify these antibodies in serum. The presence of phospholipase A2 receptor antibodies should always be correlated with clinical findings and renal biopsy to confirm disease. A result is classified as positive when the screening test is positive at 1 to 10 dilution of patient's serum. a negative result may not rule out primary membranous nephropathy, as antibodies may not be detected in early disease, with immunosuppression or in certain patients who may have disease but are truly negative for phospholipase A2 receptor IgG antibodies. Thus, in a subset of patients, renal biopsy may still be warranted even if the phospholipase A2 receptor antibody assay is negative. Phospholipase A2 receptor is a glomerular podocyte transmembrane glycoprotein. Detection of IgG antibodies to phospholipase A2 receptor and genome-wide association study confirms that the genetic susceptibility to primary membranous nephropathy involves phospholipase A2 receptor and HLA-DQ1 molecule. Furthermore, the presence of phospholipase A2 receptor IgG antibodies in association with protein in urine is specific for the diagnosis of primary membranous nephropathy. Indeed, phospholipase A2 receptor staining in renal biopsy shows good correlations with phospholipase A2 receptor IgG antibodies in serum. Patients previously negative for phospholipase A2 receptor antibodies have been reported to develop antibodies during the course of disease in follow-up investigations. Recent clinical studies have also shown that phospholipase A2 receptor IgG antibodies may precede the onset of clinical disease as measured by protein in urine. In this regard, the presence of IgG antibodies to phospholipase A2 receptor may help differentiate primary membranous nephropathy patients from those with other etiologies. In addition to the diagnostic relevance of phospholipase A2 receptor IgG antibodies in primary membranous nephropathy, autoantibody titers have been reported to be useful in the management of disease. Increasing titers of phospholipase A2 receptor IgG antibodies do correlate with disease activity as measured by the levels of protein in urine. The titers of antibodies decline in response to immunosuppressive treatment and may be useful in monitoring patients under therapy. Furthermore, the decline in phospholipase A2 receptor IgG antibody titers precede decreased urine protein levels in patients that respond to treatment. Failure to respond to treatment and/or relapse is associated with increasing antibody titers prior to occurrence of protein in urine in most patients. In the context of renal transplantation, the presence of phospholipase A2 receptor IgG antibodies pre-transplantation is associated with an increased risk for rejection. In the study shown here, patients with phospholipase A2 receptor antibodies pre-transplantation had an 83% recurrence rate compared to 58% for those who were antibody negative prior to transplantation. In conclusion, phospholipase A2 receptor IgG antibody is a novel laboratory marker to diagnose and manage patients with primary membranous nephropathy. More information on this topic can be found on the ARUP website. Thank you for your time.